Okay, so in this video, I will show you briefly how to manage permissions for Teams. And there are a couple of options you can do. First of all, when you are in the team, there is an option to manage team. And here you can add or remove members. And there are two roles that you can give to people. One is the owner role, and the second one is a member role. So owners can do everything, members can do almost everything. And also, you can add, if you have it configured properly at your tenant side, you can add guests to the team. Guests would be external people who do not belong to your organization. They can be on a different domain, and they can be added as guests. Guests have some limitations, so they do not have full experience, but they can do most of the things that members can. So this would be one option. This option is to actually manage the team. Then within each team, you can manage things like channels, right? You see in each team, let's see, in this team, there are different channels, general, budget, and our team. So if you want to modify channels and modify permissions for the channels, you can do it from here. And let's say this channel budget, right? If I click here on the manage channel, I see the following options. You know, in terms of permissions, the channel moderation is set to off. So it means that everyone can post anything they want on this channel. And then we can see who can start a new post. Everyone except guests. Right now, everyone except guests can start a new post, and here everyone. So it means even guests can start new posts on the channels. If I select this option, it would give me an option who can be a moderator. So it means moderation would be required to approve specific posts. Right, so from here, this would be channel moderation. This is an option here. But one more thing that I wanted to show you, which is kind of important. Let's say I add one more channel to the team. Right, I just call it new channel. Oh, no, let's call it challenge, right, to make it. And here under privacy, we have an option standard, or we can have private. If I create a private channel, what it means, right? Let me add someone, our business development manager, and add. So it would mean that you see this little lock here, that only people who are members in this team and who are explicitly added to this channel are able to view it. Not everyone, not for example, if I have some additional members in this team, they're able to see this channel and this one, but this one is only visible to the members who are explicitly added to this channel. So, in terms of permission management, this is one option you can go. You can have standard channels like general or budget. It means that everyone in the team can see them. And you can have hidden or private channels, which allows only people who are explicitly added here to be able to view this channel. So this is the very basic permissions management options for Teams. Let's sum up quickly. So each team can have owners and members, right? Owners can do everything, and members can do some things. You know, they can add, delete, modify things, but they cannot delete a team, for example. Then we can also add guests, external people, but they have to be configured in the admin center. There is an additional option which has to be set to make sure that guests can be added to Teams. And then there are also standard channels and private channels. Private channels are only for those who are explicitly added to the channel. And they have to be, you know, those people, they have to be added to the team first, and then they can only be added to these channels. And whatever is visible in this channel, so this post and files, they not everyone in the team will see it, right? So that's basically a very brief summary of the permissions management in Teams. I will do a more detailed video when we play with SharePoint permissions, because behind each team there is a SharePoint site which is a part of it, and the permissions can be managed more granular when we do it in SharePoint. But for this, please stay tuned. And please submit any questions or feedback. I'll get back to you on this. Have a great day and stay healthy. Bye bye.